Boys, 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 we're on radio.
Radio Gaga.
That's right. You can listen to us here on demand at the MacPack Podcast. But obviously, we're on radio, boys. Radio Frio 107.9 every Saturday from 8 till 10 a.m.
Absolutely. So this is a perfect little extra dose of the MacPack that you can get, obviously, your fans of the pod if you're tuning in, and we absolutely love you for it.
Hit us with a DM on our Instagram and we love read them out on the show.
That's right. Because every time I listen to a podcast or a show like that, I always think, what would it be like to be there in the moment with them?
In the fleshlight.
And when we do it live on radio, that's the closest you can get to being in the studio with us.
Absolutely. So come along for the ride. Utilize the radio gig that we have as the little extra bit of MacPack juice that you could get in your week.
That's Radio Fremantle, 107.9 FM.
Every Saturday from 8 to 10 a.m.
With your voice, the MacPack.
At Radio Fremantle.
That's 107.9.
With us, Jake, Joe, and Riley.
And Junior.
And fourth member, the MacPack.
On the radio.
107.9. Don't forget.
8 to 10 a.m. Every Saturday. Don't forget to tune in. And then we might go down to the beach after. Because we did that last time.
Keep it locked!
We've been doing some radio down at Radio Fremantle. That's 107.9 FM. What you're about to hear is what we chatted about there on the weekend.
You can obviously join us live each and every Saturday between 8 to 10 a.m.
But don't worry, because if you missed the episode, you can listen right here in your podcast feed.
Enjoy!
Coming to you live from the studios in Fremantle,
the three brothers.
I'm feeling fan-freaking-tastic.
Boys, boys, boys!
Is this thing on?
I wouldn't have thought so.
Welcome to the best day of the week.
It's Saturday.
TGIS.
Turn your radios on.
Crank up that dial.
Saturdays are for the bro.
The weekend's here.
You're listening to the MacPack on Radio Fremantle 107.9.
Good morning and welcome to the MacPack here on Radio Fremantle 107.9. We're here for your Saturday morning, and doesn't seem to matter when we come in the Radio Fremantle studios.
It's always a beautiful day.
Yeah, exactly. When it's summer, when it's winter. I don't feel like winter hasn't necessarily kicked in just yet. If you look out at the moment, it is absolutely crystal clear for what is 18th of May.
Yes, it's getting very close to June, which is the start of winter, but it's going to be high 20s today. We are living it up here in Frio.
Absolutely loving it. We're all back in the studio as well. Very exciting week. Joey, you took over the reins last week. Riley Boy and I used our little sick card. We're going to use our annual sick day today.
We had some sick leave and we banked it in.
Absolutely. And now Joey is rejoined by the boys.
I'm going to be. I was working hard last week doing everything. But yeah, I'll be taking the back seat today. But you know, I got a lot of good feedback, which was great. I heard you guys were listening. Thank you very much.
You actually did very well. It's tough to do radio at the best of times, let alone when you're by your lonesome. But no, you did a fantastic job. Any things that you would have thought were better without us versus better with us?
I think better with, obviously, a lot of the banter and stuff, a lot easier to go to the bathroom. Going to the bathroom is less stressful.
That's true.
When there's three people. When there's only one, I would be like, what is the longest song I have?
Did you go to the bathroom?
Multiple times.
Oh, really? Also,
in a cup. In a cup down the back.
I just had the Gatorade bottle. And I was just, stomping it in. but yeah, it's weird because when we do it in the three, there are times where we don't go to the bathroom at all, but I don't know, it's just maybe it was the pressure of being alone.
Yeah.
You're just thinking about it, yeah.
Nerves running through the veins.
There you go.
Well, no, you did a fantastic job, but yeah, it's exciting that we are all back in the Radio Fremantle studios.
It's good to be back to help you out, Joey.
Absolutely. We've got a big show lined up. We've got plenty of stuff to discuss throughout the morning to get you kicked off for your Saturday morning. We're going to be chatting about a whole bunch of things, but last week, me and Riley Boy, we had a bit of the flu. We had a bit of the cold. We didn't want anybody to catch our disease, but it's full of love. It's full of energy, and we're here to bring you a wonderful start to Saturday morning. So this week, catch that vibe. It's Ben Lee on Radio Fremantle 107.9. You're listening to Radio Fremantle 107.9 with the MacPack for your Saturday morning, a wonderful Saturday morning. That is the 18th of May, and it is only 8:06. So the weekend is at its best. It's still at its youngest. And there's still plenty of opportunity.
Boys, I've had some big news come out the gates this morning.
Far away.
Have you heard?
I'm not sure.
Have you heard? Obviously, a big staple in Australia is Vegemite. Correct. We all love a bit of Vegemite.
Yes. Fans of Vegemite, it's a pretty divisive operator.
Yep, it's controversial. I love it.
It's not controversial in Australia, but everywhere else in the world seems to think it is.
They don't know what good food is.
And they've spun off a few times, haven't they, in past time.
That's true.
I Snack 2.0.
That was controversial. That's probably before your time, almost. Yeah. That's when they came out and they wanted to, because it's so controversial, because it's so divisive, this very hectic spread
this
that we
wheat extract
to, that we seem to have. What they did was they tried to make it more appealing to a larger audience. Yep. And this was maybe 15 years ago now.
Yeah, it was ages ago.
And they basically built out a new recipe for this that was not as... It was easy to palate. It was a lot more palatable.
Yeah.
And they put like a cheesy element into it to reduce the amount of hectic yeast and like that immediate sour sort of feeling you get when you have it. And they called it... They asked people to come in and name it.
What should we call
and
it?
And it ended up being called Cheesy Mite, I think. But that was after like quite a hectic campaign and period of...
There was outcry.
Someone winning, because everyone would enter this competition. They'd all put in their names. And then they would... Eventually they... Like, went, okay, and this is the winner. And everyone was like pretty, it's Australia's food. Everyone was very up and about. And then
you
they went, it's I Snack 2.0. And everyone went, oh, that almost tastes worse than the Vegemite
Wouldn't
does.
Wouldn't have thought that. Yeah, right. But then we also had the spin-off in Shapes, Vegemite Shapes.
Yes. They still getting a run?
They sucked. They really, really sucked. But they've gone even crazier, boys.
All right.
Can you guess what type of food you reckon they would go with next?
Sushi.
Nah, it's got to be something. I think I might have even seen this, but I've completely forgotten on it.
Smith's.
Yeah, is it a Smith's chip? Smith's chip love doing like random
They love a collab.
Stuff.
No, it's worse than that, boys. It's our friends over at Maggi. The 2-minute noodles.
Oh.
They're getting a Vegemite.
That's quite concerning.
Literally on the Coles shelves as we speak. Maggi Vegemite noodles.
That's a bit hectic.
My God.
I can't imagine that tasting good because like the best part about Vegemite is doing a very thin spread on toast.
Yeah.
It's like a complimentary
You can't
good.
Have it sort of
but
soak up.
This is the
up.
Main ingredient.
Yeah, that is it. That's what you're going to get. That'd be a very salty.
And is it like, that's so, but is it like chicken noodles or something like that with Vegemite? Or is it just Vegemite?
It tastes like Vegemite. The full thing's just full bung of Vegemite.
It's Vegemite.
Because
that's
they're quite noticeable. If you get a beef one, if you get a chicken one, like it doesn't matter what like type you get, you can 100% taste the difference because it's the only flavour that's in there.
Yeah.
Where if it, like Vegemite is good as part of something, like it's in a moderation. You can't just sort of bathe in it and then hope that it's going to come out tasting decent. I reckon the worst they could ever do, and knowing Vegemite and how well they collaborate, let's not say it's probably on the agenda somewhere, but I reckon like a Colgate Vegemite would have to be the worst.
Oh my God.
It would have to be the absolute worst.
But people get those, like charcoal toothpastes.
Yeah, that's
They're
what
meant
I mean.
To be for like whitening
I'm
or something.
I'm sure they don't taste as terrible.
Put a bit of the Australia's spread in there.
Imagine you've also put a hot tip down the bottom of the Coles product details and they said, hot tip. Add 1/2 tablespoon of butter and 1 tablespoon of grated cheese to enhance the richness.
Oh, so even they're saying this is not good by
you
itself.
Need to distract it with cheese a bit of cheese.
It's a bit of a macaroni Vegemite.
Yeah, it's like putting parmesan on your bloody Maggi noodles.
It's very gourmet. I don't know if I like it. What do you reckon would be the best thing to put on like your noodles?
Just, you got to keep it simple. Chicken noodles, baby.
Yeah, I think sometimes like the reason that we've only invented so many things is because that's all we need.
That is. Yeah, that's exactly it. Don't complicate it.
Exactly right. You're listening to the Backpack here on Radio Fremantle 107.9. You're listening to the Mac Pack on Radio Fremantle 107.9 for your Saturday morning, 8:20 here on as I always seem to say, beautiful.
Beautiful morning.
Beautiful.
Well, last week it was a bit cloudy.
Oh.
I was mixing it up
Maybe
with the weather description.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
We bring the weather. We bring the good fine weather. The fine boys bring the fine weather.
Speaking of...
anyway.
Speaking of places with bad weather, I've got some news coming in from England.
Oh, my God.
Oh, true.
More news.
Mate, if they had a day like this...
we call would off the school, everyone. Work's done. Let's head out to the stony beaches. But they're a little bit worried over in England.
Uh-oh. What's happening?
They're worried about some things dying out.
Oh.
There are some classic British insults that young people aren't using enough. There's too much Gen Z slang and not enough baby boomer slang.
Oh, right.
And these are dying out.
Well, the language tends to die with the characters that use
with
the
people who use it. Yeah, but I think they're doing a push to try and revitalize some of these insults.
Okay.
And I love that. They only seem to be worried about the insults.
Oh, all the normal languages remain.
Yeah. So these are some the ones that made the headline: pillock, plonker, and tosspot.
Okay, let's go through each of them, Joey.
Yep.
And let's see. So go around the first one. We'll see if we know, because we're somewhat familiar with them.
Yeah. So the first one is pillock.
Pillock.
Does it just mean like idiot? Like, is that the equivalent of us just calling someone a bit of a thick idiot?
You pillock. I don't want to offend anyone. I just keep repeating that word.
Yeah, it means a stupid person, according to the Oxford Dictionary, and they would know, because that is in England.
And that's in, like, the dictionary.
It'd be in the dictionary, yeah.
Because I thought they didn't put, like, I guess it's not a swear word, it's an insult.
Insult, yeah.
Yeah, because they don't put swear words in the dictionary, do they?
I think they do.
Okay.
But I think there's a little disclaimer that it's a swear.
Oh, a bit of an E. I put a little E next to it.
I would know that. I don't. The next one is plonker.
Plonker.
I would have thought that was near on the same thing.
That is a term, right? That's got to be.
You're
plonker, yeah. I've done a few plonkers in my day.
Because of the sound.
Joe just did a plonker.
Joe just left the shit out of it. Plonker.
What's a plonker mean?
Plonker is a foolish or inept person.
So similar.
Yeah. There's a full list, and a lot of them are in that vein, but this one's a little bit different. This one is a tosspot.
Okay, but again, I would probably just say, like, maybe more of a waste of time. They're just like, again, I'd just say sort of idiot. I feel like the reason they're dying out isn't because they're old. I feel like it's because they've got 18 different words for the same thing.
Yeah, and we've sort of landed on idiot.
Yeah, exactly.
Now, this one, it's interesting. It's got two definitions. One is a stupid or obnoxious person, which is, you know,
again,
all,
I feel
all
like stupid's appeared in all three.
But the second one is a heavy drinker.
Ooh.
So if someone's
plonker,
someone's getting on it a bit too much,
then you're a tosspot.
You're a tosspot. My favourite one is got to be scallywag.
Oh, that's good.
That's good. That is like kind of endearing in Australia.
Yeah.
Though.
Isn't that what scallywag, like Captain Feathersword used to say to the kids?
Scallywag.
Yeah.
He was slurring on
TV.
Dad
calls us scallywags.
He calls us plenty of stuff. Not so to go with that.
Yeah, made it more extreme.
Yeah, so it's a scallywag, the actual definition, is probably what we think it is.
Okay.
A person, typically a child, who behaves badly, but in an amusing, mischievous way rather than a harmful way. They're a bit of a rascal.
Yeah, okay.
So it's like,
I don't mind that.
You scallywag. It's like you're not doing what you should be doing, but you're doing it well.
It's very much, I'd never call like a mate of mine a scallywag. It's very much something that like your pop would say to you as a 4-year-old kid.
And that's a scallywag. Why they're dying out. You're out with the boys. Maybe one of them's been a bit of a scallywag and you got to let them know.
There you go. I like it. What's your favorite, if you had like one little insult in Australian terms, what would your favorite insult be that you hope never dies out?
If you're enjoying this week's episode of the podcast, the best thing that you can do to show us a little bit of support is to share it with your mates. Whether it's a story on Instagram, a private message to a pal,
a DM.
Slide into those DMs. Do whatever you need be. Or even just like message your mum and be like, these guys, they swear a lot, but like,
I prefer Gmail
Yeah, Gmail's good.
Gmail's good.
It's slow. Like, it's a very slow and formal way.
I click on any link I get.
fair enough. So yeah, chuck it on your Instagram story or send it to a mate. But whatever you do, we just want to grow this little baby pack.
Fantastic. And then every week you can chat about the pack with your pack.
There you go. Exactly.
Ooh, that's a good one. We'll head over to Riley while I think.
Is it a bit of a thinker? We can leave it. We can come back to it. Have a little bit of think over the break. If you guys listening along at home in your cars want to get in contact with your favourite piece of insult, I guess, like an Australian insult that you love running with, keep them.
Actually,
we would like to share them if possible. But get in contact with us via the MacPack on Facebook or on Instagram. Just slide to our DMs and let us know. Mind you, we get a fair few insults, so we can probably just read out the inbox without any new entries. So yeah,
get TikTok comments,
and we'll come back and let you know some of our absolute favourites. This one is Beautiful Thing. You're listening to the MacPack here on Radio Fremantle 107.9. You're listening to the MacPack here on Radio Fremantle 107.93, the magic number.
That's us, baby.
Love it. Wasn't three last week, Joey.
Nope, it was just me.
It was a one-man band.
But we were on before this break, we were talking about classic British insults, and now we're going to come back with some classic Aussie insults.
Yes.
So I've got my three favourites.
Yes.
Huge. So the first one, it's got to be buffhead.
Buffhead. Do you use it often?
The buff.
Yeah, the person who uses it most, I would say, is our mum.
Oh,
she loves buffhead.
Does she?
Like someone maybe watching the footy.
Yeah, I was going to say AFL player.
And there's kind of like that one guy on a team who's maybe loves a bit of a fight, loves a bit of a push and shove, that kind of stuff.
That's true.
He's a bit of a buffhead, really.
Yeah, that's a good one. I don't mind that.
He's a buffhead.
Another one is drongo.
Yeah, which I think is one that's dying out. I reckon in like the 60s, drongo was pretty heavy, but I reckon I wouldn't have heard drongo this year.
What does drongo mean?
It's one of those classic, just stupid guy. But I was looking up, I was trying to find the origin because it seems to be an Aussie thing. It seems to be based off a racehorse.
Oh, okay. Oh.
I guess it must have been a bad racehorse, but I couldn't find too much on the source of that. But I think if you want to hit someone with an insult and you really want to get to them, you got to go with champ.
Yeah, and that has flipped over time. That's language that maybe 20, 30 years ago was considered like, even I'd say 10 years ago was considered positive.
We love a few like reverse, like it sounds like an endearing term, but you're using it in a negative way.
Yeah, and it really, you can call someone like a champ and it be good.
Yeah.
It's just the way you say it. Even if like, oh, great work, champion.
Yeah.
Or great work, champion. It's just, yeah.
I've got a few in similar vein.
The delivery.
The word mate can be spun to be a good thing. Yeah, whatever, mate.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I feel like it's back-ended or front-ended. That's when you get your context with mate. I always say
mate. How you going?
The big issue I fall into a category is I call everyone mate, and then I've called like ladies mates, and I don't know that they take to it as...
if it's gender neutral or not.
Yeah. Mm. I don't know if they're loving it as much as... my male friends.
Couple of other ones. Chief.
Chief's good. I like chief. I think that's positive. I reckon if you're calling someone chief, that's the best. Like everyone's up and about that.
Big fella.
I reckon that's positive as well.
No, but you can spin it. Yeah, grow up, big fella.
I think if you just say grow up on...
Yeah.
If you grow up... If you
agree, I think Riley's favorite insult is grow up.
He's my favorite. Ready? Turbo.
That's... Yeah, no one's positively being called a turbo.
And you could definitely spin the word hero. Ah, yeah, hero.
Yeah.
Yeah, big hero.
It's all Riley's stuff is just being sarcastic.
Yeah, Riley's is all in the delivery. The words alone, they're actually like quite nice.
Riley just had a list of 10 random words, and then like, baby, say it mean. Yeah, doesn't sound nice.
Somehow.
Grow up, turbo.
We did throw it out to the people to get involved, and we got a couple of fantastic messages. Our first one came in from Poppy, who said... let me know if we're not allowed to go with this. Gob and then the S word. So gob.
Oh, yeah. But you really extend the I.
Yeah, a bit of an E at the end. So, yeah, anyway.
Yeah, bit of an I.
That's well said. And bollocks. I feel like bollocks is a very interesting, probably, bollocks. That's very English.
Bollocks.
Yeah.
I think that, doesn't that mean your plums?
I think it does.
The crown jewels.
Yeah, bollocks. But then there's even like stuff plums. Like that as it leaves the vernacular.
Yeah.
You don't know what it means.
Yeah.
Yeah, the further you get away from it,
yeah.
It starts to discern from what it...
A lot of them have to do with those kind of things.
Yeah, a lot of them have to do with, like, private parts,
uh-oh.
Excretion.
Oh,
dangerous.
Or just a stupid guy. Being stupid is really one of the worst things it can be, apparently.
My favourite, and it's such a negative saying, but it's more of like, instead of going with, oh my God, our father runs with Pickle Me Grandmother.
Pickle Me Grandmother.
And
what does that even mean?
And we've just always grown up with that being in the vernacular.
Pickle Me Grandmother.
With no explanation and never hearing it from basically anyone outside of him and like two of his mates.
That is
Gandhi used to run with Pickle Me Grandmother.
Even if we asked Dad, what is Pickle Me Grandmother? He wouldn't have a definition.
It doesn't mean, yeah. That is a funny thing you can do as like a parent, is just make up things.
And just let the kids think. Yeah.
Because I've done that. I've said things that Dad says. And people
loud.
Are like, you're right.
Like the thing with Pickle Me Grandmother as well, like our grandmother was his mum. Is it a good thing to say Pickle Me Grandmother?
No, but then his grandmother is his mum's mum.
Yeah, exactly.
So it's she's being pickled.
She's been pickled for a while.
Pickle Me Grandmother. What does that mean?
They put him in a jar with some brine.
With brine.
There you go. We absolutely love to hear it. We love to hear everyone's opinions on the matter as well. So thank you so much to Poppy and everyone else who got involved with the show. Next up, we got a little bit of My Happiness from Powderfinger. You're listening to The Mac Pack here on Radio Fremantle 107.9. You're listening to The Mac Pack here on Radio Fremantle 107.9 for a beautiful Saturday morning.
Boys, I was feeling hungry the other day. As
yes,
you do.
Yes, as you do.
As you do. And I was thinking, I was
relatable
like...
relatable stuff.
That's right. You've got to be open to the market. Anyway.
Colin, have you been hungry?
Another song.
Anyway, so I was driving around, and we're very fortunate enough to live where we have essentially every fast food place near our house. We have a Nando's.
We do.
We have a Taco Bell, Zambrero's, KFC.
There's GYG now.
HJ's, Oporto, GYG, Subway, Domino's, legit
ching,
all.
Ching, 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 ching. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. And they're all sponsoring us.
Yeah, use the discount code.
And they're all within like a 200-meter radius of the house, essentially. Yeah. So you're spoiled for options. Sometimes it's actually quite hard because you're like, I could have anything. The world is my oyster. What do I choose? And on this day, I was like, I'm feeling fresh. I'm feeling healthy. Let's get a bit of Subway.
Okay, nice. Subway's always had that concept of everyone thinking it's very healthy.
Yep, marketing geniuses.
And if you actually like dig a little bit deeper,
it's just a apparently big, long burger.
That might not be as accurate as they depict.
Anyways, but it tastes elite, right?
Which is usually how you know if it's healthy or not. The better it tastes, the worse it is for you, is a general rule to live by, I reckon.
Anyway, so I jump in, and it's kind of busy in there. There's one bloke in front of me.
Yeah, so they're bumping.
And there's only two sandwich artists, right?
Are they still running with that term?
I think so.
Like, give me a spell. Is that on your LinkedIn? Sandwich artists.
It is
artists.
Actually. You can add that. I looked when I got LinkedIn, I looked at a few sandwich artists. I needed to connect. Anyway, so I got in line and this guy was like, you know, he'd already chose Italian herb and cheese and he's getting bloody chicken tenders or whatever.
The best canvas for your sandwich art.
Yeah. As I walk in, he's already getting cheese put on his bread.
Okay.
And I walk in and I'm standing there and the lady's like, what can I get you? And I was like, bloody meatball, Italian herb and cheese, cheddar cheese. And she's like, no worries. But for some reason, my sandwich artist is a little bit more experienced and is a bit quicker than the previous sandwich artist.
Okay, right.
So
apprentice
so she
sandwich artist
picks up my sandwich, which has meatballs and cheese, as the other lady still putting on cheese, picks it up, walks around her,
ooh,
and slams it down on the salad side, and then I'm caught in this crossfire. We've created an X of a conversation, so now I'm caught in that awkward position, which we've all been in many times. The Subway line jump.
Yeah, the leapfrog.
I feel bad for just cutting in past this guy.
It's an awkward one because it's got nothing to do with you either. Did you get yours put in the oven?
No.
That's often the reason.
Yeah, I'm in and out.
The toaster, if you're in the toaster, you got to take a step back.
Yeah, yeah.
You're not up against the glass. No. You're getting toasted.
I don't think you should ever be up against the glass.
You've got to see the produce.
Fucking up the glass. Excuse me, mate. Can you just get off the glass? We're not in prison. You don't have to be on the glass. Yeah.
But yeah, and then, you know, I jump it, I pay, I'm out of there. But before the time he passes the cheese.
How much cheese is this guy getting?
It's just like a quad decker of cheese.
No, but he also went to the, you know, he went to the oven and stuff. So, like, it's just melting cheese. He spent so long on cheese that I could get in and get out before he finishes the cheese.
Yeah, it's awkward when, like, the people ahead of you, say it's like a couple or a family, and now you're in the middle of the family.
Because
the kids get toasted. Maybe the mum's not getting toasted.
It's only awkward when, like, it's awkward at the time.
It's only awkward when you're trying to get them to pay.
Yeah, exactly. You're standing there and they're like, okay, you guys all together? And you're standing there going, yep. And they're like, I've never met this one in my life.
When it is really, really, really busy, it gets awkward because it's like they usually have people on bait. So it's like Sarah would be doing salad.
Yeah.
You know?
You're getting a collab.
And you're spinning, you're going from Cassandra to Sandra to
another
Andrew. And by the time it gets to the person who's doing the paying, they don't know whose sandwich this is.
Yeah. It's a
they're
mystery.
Just rolling it and then scanning it.
They also sometimes get it and they have no idea what's in it.
Yeah, absolutely.
The cheap one.
I love a little bit of an awkward interaction. That's my favourite. When it should be a seamless process, but it ends up being an awkward interaction. Yeah. Have a little think over the break. Come back to me with some more little awkward interactions. People listening at home, do the same. Get in contact with us. Awkward little interactions that shouldn't be awkward. Like, if you're thinking about them now,
yep.
they're not awkward. But then you find yourself in a peculiar situation. You go, oh, how's this worked out?
Yeah, yeah, this has gone really bad.
Exactly. This is as bad as it could have gone. And no one's getting hurt. No one's getting harmed.
I'm just trying to get a sandwich.
Yeah, I'm just in the dark over here. There you go. We love to hear it. You're listening to the MacPack here on Radio Fremantle 107.9. This is Robbie Williams with Angels to kick off your Saturday morning. You're listening to the MacPack here at Radio Fremantle 107.9.
Lovely.
We're talking about awkward situations. And you had your example from Subway.
That's right.
One thing I hate is when you're at a shop and maybe there's a few people serving.
Yes.
And I think the line can either be two snakes or one snake, but like a double-headed python.
Yeah.
As in one snake that breaks into two.
Ah.
And when people start doing their own thing.
There
needs to be an established system. Like last night we were at a burger joint and I went to order.
Yes.
And I wanted to get in to get drinks while happy hour was still going on, right?
Obviously.
And they had about six different people serving and each of them just had one little wine.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Perfect. It's very clear set up. So I go, okay, there's one guy there, I'm going to stand behind him. And I'm standing there and the clock is ticking because I'm like, it's like 5:56. You know, I got to get in before this happy hour.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But the guy in front of me was getting Guinness.
Ooh.
And Guinness, they pour. And then they have a nice little, I think it's meant to be like a minute and a half break.
Because it's got to wait. They pour half the beer and then it waits.
And then you pour the other half. Yeah. So I had to ditch the line.
He jumped.
Yeah, but it was a good setup. It was clear I could find someone else. Okay, this person's already paying. I can get in behind them. But when there's just a bunch of people and they're just trying to be served,
yeah,
it causes chaos.
That's fair.
Facts.
My worst is when you go to like a fuel bowser. Firstly, because you're in the cars, or you can't just like quickly, swiftly move out the way.
Yeah.
But sometimes I'll arrive and the person at the front is taking way too long. They've got two fuel tanks to fill up. Right?
Yeah, so they've got jerry cans.
The moment you see someone bring jerry
cans.
Something else.
What does he know?
Yeah.
Did I get a jerry can?
The moment you see someone get out of the car with a jerry can, it's over. But you often, like, I find myself parked. Let's say we're three back and there's a two Bowser, right?
Yeah.
And I'm the third one back. And then you quickly work out that the person in front is taking longer than the person in the middle.
Mm.
So then you are forced to... So let's say the second person veers out and leaves, right? Pretty tough to do. Pretty tricky to
do. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And then you're sat there, right? So now it's the person filling up who's halfway through. Then you, fresh, and then a person behind you. And the person in front is quicker than you because they're basically done.
They're done.
So they leave. So now it's no one, you, and a person behind you.
Yeah.
And you're like, well, this person, I can't. I'm
holding them up.
Yeah. And for anyone who's just arriving on the scene, they're like, has this work not driven all the way through?
What about people who do the, you know, you pull up, most people, I guess, have their fuel tank on the left-hand side of their car.
Correct.
Some people have it on the right. That's got to be a dream because you're getting all the good things.
But pay more? Do you reckon you pay more to get it on the right?
Yeah, yeah.
Because no one says
what I've done is I've drilled a hole. But what about the people? Because I'll occasionally go to the right one.
Oh, I'm a big stretcher. I love doing
a pullover.
Yeah. Because
those things have, those hoses have.
Yeah, you can.
Although a few times I haven't, they couldn't reach.
Then you have to
pull back and like move slightly closer.
But the thing is, you get out of your pull up, then you get out of your car, grab the hose, and then you're trying to work it, doesn't work. So then you've got to make that shameful walk back to your car to rearrange your car.
Yeah, and you move it like
in front of like because the fact that you're going in on the right hand side means that so you're putting on a real display in front of
there's an audience.
But what about the people who they have a left tank?
Yes.
And then they just drive in the other way. They make the right one on left.
That's clever. I've never heard of that.
People do it. I reckon
you can't do it when it's busy.
You can't be nose to nose.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah,
head on collision.
Yeah, because then it's like it's chaos. So there can't be lines going in any
it's
which
chaos.
Way.
It's bloody chaos. My biggest faux pas is definitely happens at the footy a lot. Bloody hate a very packed toilet.
Yeah, that's fair.
Especially at the footy, there's just all these lads of every age, and everyone's just shoulder to shoulder, rubbing shoulders and trying to do the thing.
Yeah.
Do that thing.
We did throw it out to the people, and actually our darling mother got in contact on this occasion and said, and this was a funny story. The reason I'm reading this one out, because we were all witness to this.
We were there.
And this is like, it's an awkward situation, but fortunately for us, we were on the positive end. She goes, when you're waiting in a Macca's waiting bay, so you ordered, then you go into the waiting bay. Often that's a bit of it. You're like, oh, this is going
to
take.
Yeah,
surely you've got the chips ready. Like, this is all you're doing all day. Just crank the chips out. Just keep them coming.
Also, if like you park in bay two, because there's someone, in, and then the bay one. It's just a very
well. We're getting to that because they then mum goes, and then they bring out a huge order for you. Like, it's a massive bag. Yeah, and this is what happened to us once. But you've only ordered like a sundae.
Yeah.
And you don't really say anything. you just absolutely
I remember
book
we
all, it.
What did we ordered like four fries and Cokes or whatever, and we got like seven family meals.
I think we did order food.
No, we did. Yeah, we 100% ordered food in the bag. And the bag didn't seem like it seemed like a reasonable enough to put it all in this bag. Yeah. And then we drove off.
I think we just got like cheeseburgers and then we're for now Big Macs and quarter pounders and nuggets.
It was absolutely mammoth.
I do remember it was actually like...
With all due respect, it was fair enough. We were not aware of just how much food there was in there until we'd driven off, and we were like, oh.
And the worst part
we've hit the mother load, boys.
The worst part was the guy sitting in the other bay waiting for that meal.
Yeah, it was a friend.
We were all friends.
Friend of the show.
Never came up in gumbo.
And they had a big family. Like, imagine that. Imagine ordering that much food and then you get given like four burgers.
And we're all laughing, driving off, waving it.
Yeah, because we drove around to the park.
Yeah, we did a bit of a hearty.
Yeah, we smashed it down.
eat the evidence.
That's what we ordered, I thought.
I love it. You're here with the Mac Pack on your Saturday morning. This is one of my absolute all-time favourite songs from yesteryear. It's Into the Night by the man Santana and the king of Nickelback, Chad Kroeger. You're listening to the Mac Pack on Radio Fremantle 107.9. Beautiful Saturday morning. It's just ticked over 9:13 on a fantastic... Is it autumn?
Yeah, it is autumn.
They're lying to us, Joe.
I haven't seen a single yellow leaf.
Yeah, that's true. Is that fall? They don't fall down? Or the leaves?
Fall is what Americans call
autumn. Yeah, I know. Yeah, but we're an international platform.
We've got lots around our house.
Have they?
We do?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, true, yeah. When I go on my walks, I step on them. But they're more brown. And they make a really nice...
They do. They're crispy.
The simple joys.
Do you think it'll end up being colder later as well? Do you reckon we're going to have a cold December as a result of basically still being summer
I
now?
Think so. I think eventually we'll need to
catch up,
change the old seasons around.
There you go.
That's it. Boys, have you been feeling lucky recently? Because this lady has.
Oh.
Woman wins 1 million lottery jackpot twice in 10 weeks.
That's mammoth.
That's
man.
The headline from Sky News in Massachusetts.
Massachusetts. Massachusetts.
Over in America. That's right. She bought two different tickets, spent... roughly $10 to $15 on each one.
Right. That's good investment.
At two different places in 10 weeks and won the $1 million lottery twice.
It's crazy. If I won $1 million in lotto,
yep.
I think I'd be like,
not doing this
I'm
again.
Done with lotto. Like, yeah. I won.
Yeah, you wouldn't double invest.
Yeah, I guess it's not like, it's a lot of money, but it's not like...
$1 million, isn't it? No.
It's not like Island in the Caribbean money, which is if you're playing lotto...
That's what you're. Oh,
that's what you're going for.
Winning it twice, not bad at all.
Yeah,
but then fair. I was thinking, I was like, what are the chances in that? One in 250 million, twice. How hectic is that?
And the odds change because it's not just like one in 500 and something million.
Yeah, that's just a rough estimate over the years. One in 250 million is to win around that much in lotto in America.
That's impressive. Good on her. I think what you would do is tell people. I wouldn't come out the second time I've won it.
She's put it on the news.
Yeah, exactly.
I wouldn't tell anyone if I won it.
Yeah, especially...
Like when I won it last... sorry.
Especially like if you won it the first time, you tell people. And then the second time, it's just like a sneaky. That one's just for you.
Yeah.
It's a bit like the Macca's order we talked about before. Like, you ordered Macca's. Yeah. Everyone knows you got Macca's, but no one knows just how much.
Wait 10 years and then talk about it on the radio. That's what I would do.
Yeah, wait till it's all gone. It's an interesting one. What would you do if you won the cash? Won any amount of cash at the water? Would you tell people? What would you do?
No. Wouldn't say a word.
Yeah, so because I obviously studied statistics at uni, so I was very anti-lotto because there's not much chance.
Yeah. Right.
But I'm actually in a lotto syndicate at work.
The word syndicate always sounds bad.
It sounds dodgy.
Like, yeah, it sounds like you're about to rob a bank.
Yeah. But I'm in the work syndicate because like...
You guys
if they
out.
Win...
Yeah, you don't want to be the only one that rocks out of it.
It's worth my $7 a week or whatever.
Must be nice.
To... If they all won, I would be devastated. Like
that's fair.
I mean, I'd be happy for him.
I'd just be bloody jealous.
There was one guy who won a bunch of money on a scratchy, I think it was like a local kind of news story.
Oh, I have seen this video. This is from a way back.
Yeah. It was in Australia. This guy won money on a scratchy, and then they were doing like a news story about him. And then so they're like, we need to get some like B-roll of you like doing a scratchy or whatever. Yeah. And he won. He was doing the B-roll.
He won more, yeah.
And he was like sobbing, like he was crying. He couldn't fathom it. It's actually a really cute video. He's just like an average Australian dude. And yeah, he literally just starts scratching out the scratchy and he turns around to the camera and he's like, I can't believe it. I won. And everyone thought he was like taking the P1 double five.
It's not a reenactment.
Yeah, all right.
Everyone was like, yeah, I'll get it. That was pretty energetic the first time. And he goes, no, like I've genuinely won it again. And he like falls onto the counter in absolute tears. We'll see if we can find the video. It's absolutely hilarious.
But yeah, it's scary. Like someone could just grab that and run.
The scratchy.
Yeah, the camera operator just throws the camera down.
Yeah.
Boom. That's mine, baby.
Boom game.
There was a guy in America. He won $1.9 billion.
That's too much money.
In April.
On Lotto.
On Lotto, yeah.
Billion is a lot.
Yeah. But then they have like a massive tax on the winnings.
Oh.
So you don't actually win that much. I mean, obviously, you know, he's still a billionaire, but...
Yeah, you'd still be in the billions. Yeah.
There you go. We want to hear from you.
Good, man.
What's the best thing you've ever won over the journey? Because whenever I do a scratchy, like it costs me $2. I win $2 back. And I'm like, well, that was a waste of time.
When have you ever got extremely lucky?
We want to hear from you. You're listening to The Mac back here on Saturday afternoon, Saturday morning for Radio Fremantle 107.9. You're listening to The Mac back on Radio Fremantle 107.9. We've had a wonderful little morning.
Yes, it's been great weather, as we've mentioned.
And in the Radio Fremantle studios, Joey's joined with the brothers again.
Yes, back.
It's been quite nice. Full bill of health as well from the boys.
Yes, fantastic. Yeah, it was funny. I'd always say, you're listening to the Mac back, but just me. You've got to keep the brand alive.
Good man. But no, it's been a fun morning. We've been discussing about a whole bunch of different things. At the moment, we're on the topic of winning.
Hashtag winning.
Namely prizes. So like you've just discussed the lottery winner who was able to bag $1 million 1 week and then 10 weeks later win another $1 million in the lotto, which is a very, very heavy. That can't happen. That seems incredibly outrageous.
Must be nice.
And we threw it out to the people. What is the weirdest thing or the smallest thing or the best thing that you've ever won over the journey? Give us a little bit of interesting winnings and we'll take it from there.
Yeah, so I remember... When I was in year one, right?
Yes.
We had a school raffle.
Nice.
And they announced it over the PA system.
That used to be such a moment. And then you work out that it's like an 8-year-old kid going, is anybody...
Yeah.
this is Jeffrey from 3.1.
Yeah.
And the winner is...
Yeah. And I had won. I won one of the big prizes.
What'd you win?
I got a big... red stuffed dragon.
I remember this dragon.
Yeah, which was basically just, you know, a big sort of... It took up a lot of space and it sort of wasn't ever used. But when I won it, I was like, this is it.
That's actually a big moment because the school was like 600 deep. A lot of people would have had multiple raffle tickets. Like the chances of winning that.
I know.
And little Joey gets up there.
Yeah.
And the thing was almost bigger than you. I remember you walking out of the school. I was like, oh my... Because I was at the same school. Mm. Heard it over. I was like... What?
And my guy.
Everyone turns around like, I'd won it. And I'm like, oh my God, yeah. And I was like,
not me.
Yeah. That's not my name.
Not me. Yeah, but I always found that it was always the same kids that won the raffles in school.
Oh. Yeah, their parents were bankrolling the ticket.
There's an inside job going on.
Like that. But I never ever won a raffle. Or never.
Did you ever buy a ticket?
No, I think.
I reckon we might have gotten to the bottom of that quite quickly.
No, but I swear, it's just some people just get lucky.
They do.
And they always win.
They're up all night to get lucky. One of the best, probably the most common things that I've found over the journey is the little McDonald's Monopoly piece.
Yep.
But predating that, I vividly remember you'd go to the footy on like a Saturday morning and you'd ping over to the canteen and you'd grab yourself a Mars bar.
Oh, yeah.
And they always had, they had this competition. It was like 1 in 3 win an instant Mars bar.
Yeah.
And I like those sorts of prizes because the Monopoly one, it's like, yeah, you win a Toyota Land Cruiser if you get 4 tickets. And you're like... Man, even if I get 4 tickets, I'm not going to be able to keep them or what do I do with them? Like, they're all this big. They're like as big as your fingernail. What are you going to do with that?
And everyone knows, like, no one's buying the Monopoly stuff to win the TV.
No.
They're doing it to get a free burger.
Exactly right.
Because that's within the realm of possibility.
Correct. And you only need one.
Yeah.
You don't need to get home and lay out all your little barcodes. But that was my favorite thing about the Mars Bus. was you could knock off a Mars bar, open up the wrapper, and then it's like, you've won another Mars bar. And then you just head straight back to the canteen. And they're like, absolutely, congratulations. You want to go again? And you'd go, yeah, well, I'm hooked
on the sugar and the gambling.
Going to get another Mars bar. And, mate, best morning of your life if you bagged a Mars bar for free.
Yeah. And, yeah, I still remember the way it was written in the inside of the wrapper. Yeah. You've won. It's like, this is the greatest.
Paddle Pops used to do a very similar thing.
The ice cream
company, yeah. You used to lick the stick, and then you get down to the very bottom of the stick, and then it was like, congratulations, another paddle pop.
And then you just made the journey. It's like $2.
Less. It was like 80 cents for a paddle pop.
Make
the journey back. you got to love it. That's all. We need to get back to that. I feel like we've gotten a bit too tech savvy over the journey now. It's like, okay, now you go and buy your Big Mac, and then you got to download this app and put in all your information. Yeah. And then, no, you didn't win nothing, unfortunately. Like, that's just a real damn shame.
Yeah, I just need a bit of wood with the picture of an ice cream.
Exactly.
That's all I need to be happy with.
We'll fill in the gap from there. You're listening to the Mac Pack here on Radio Fremantle. Quite a heavy intro, Joey, on this one. Quite the heavy intro. You're listening to the Mac Pack here on Radio Fremantle 107.9. It's just ticked over 9:30, and we're having a wonderful start to the weekend. You're listening to the Mac Pack on Radio Fremantle 107.9. Wonderful Saturday morning. Get you on your way for your weekend. What are you boys up to for the rest of the weekend?
I am going to a bathhouse.
What?
A bathhouse.
Bird box.
Are you going...
You're going to have to give
us
a bit more.
It's like sauna. It's got cold stuff.
Oh.
So me and my partner are going there for... We were going to go for our anniversary, but obviously I was sick around the time, so we didn't want to book it in.
That's fair.
Too close. So
tough,
yeah, we're going
there. Because you're sick every second week.
So yeah, I'm sick now.
No, but this will be good. Yeah, it's like a relaxation kind of thing. I've never been to one like that.
Sauna, ice bath.
Are you ice bathing?
I think that's one of the things. Yeah.
You're going to have to video some of it.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know if I'll have my phone and
surely,
stuff.
Surely, cashies.
Are we unplugged?
Get a spawn con.
Yeah.
What'd you call it? Yeah, that's cool. Have you ever been in a sauna or an ice bath before?
Yeah, I've been in a sauna before at hotels and stuff.
You didn't like it.
It's a bit warm.
So I remember we all went in and then within like 30 seconds.
It's been hot in here. Oh, yeah, funny. It's weird.
That was my first time. I've gotten used to it. I don't mind it.
How many times have you done?
Yeah. Oh, a couple of times.
Number.
That's not a number.
I don't know.
Two?
Two, three, four even. I don't know.
He's gotten used to it. I like it. I'll never forget the... It was the most recent time that we were in Melbourne. We went to a hotel and we went to a sauna. And me and him went in. And he was in there for the best part of 19 seconds before he turned to me and went, it's pretty hot in here.
That one was broken. That was a faulty
zone. It does feel a bit like you're like suffocating, just breathing in such hot air.
You just got to embrace suffocation.
Once you start like actually being drenched, it's such a good feeling.
Yeah, okay. I'll keep that in mind.
You got to stick fat for like 10, 15.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
And then it's good to get out and then come back in. You don't want the ice bath. Yeah, I think that
you're not going to want to get back in, yeah.
No, I think you'll struggle with the ice bath as well. Every week post this, we go, we'll go down to the beach, and you go, it's a bit cold.
Yeah, but also the beach is just a hassle. That's my problem with the beach. Anyway, we'll talk about that another time.
What about yourself, Jinwei? What are you up to?
No ice baths, just the 21st. And we're going to see a comedy show tomorrow night, boys.
We are. Will Anderson's in town.
Love a bit of stand-up.
Big fan of Will. That'll be good. 21st, whereabouts?
Bloody.
Send the addy.
We're trekking out to Midvale for this 21st.
There you go.
Midvale.
Have you been to a party in Midvale?
Nope. I don't know where Midvale is.
Yeah, I don't think I've ever been to Midvale full stop. I don't think we need
Midvale.
Exclusively talk about party. Well, that's exciting. Good friend of yours. Good friend of the shows.
What about you, Jakey?
I'm actually off to the Perth Thunder. When I say the Perth Thunder, what do you think of?
The weather forecast.
Yeah.
It's an ice hockey team that I didn't know existed until a matter of weeks ago. Wow. I didn't know we had ice hockey here.
Me neither. That's news to me, Jake.
So I'm off to there. They're playing in Malaga at the big old arena. The ice hockey rink. Yeah. I'm
intrigued.
I don't think I've ever been. I'm not really much of a ice hockey operator.
An ice man.
I'm actually going as part of like a work thing.
Oh, Takashi.
Well, yeah. Hey, no, not quite. But I'm going. But I'm very fearful. I've got bad knees, got bad limbs. I don't want to be asked to get on the ice.
Yeah, I don't think you will.
And we've got a super sub coming on.
You can be goalie.
Imagine that, though. Do you ever, like when you were a kid, did you ever think that when you go into the footy, you'd like just like build up this narrative in your head and you're like, well, I'm going to be there. So should I bring my boots? Because like, chances are someone might get hurt. Yeah, I could probably just be like, yeah, you know what? I'll be here.
I never thought that ever.
You get it in movies a fair bit. They attend like a college basketball game and they're like, well, out of nowhere, it's this bloke sitting up in the bleachers and they're like, okay, we need this guy. This guy's going to come and save the game. That'll be me tonight, the ice hockey. So feel free to
bring your skates.
Yeah, exactly.
Right. Your puck.
What'd you call it?
Very exciting indeed. You're listening to the Mac Pack and Radio Fremantle 107.9. I know. You're listening to the Mac Pack on Radio Fremantle 107.9. A little bit of Luft Balloons, 99 Luft Balloons. What language is that?
German.
What's a Luft Balloon?
The germs.
In other news?
Well, yeah, what is a Luft Balloon? Joey, you're our international correspondent.
Well, I know the English version of the song is called 99 Red Balloons.
Right.
So I don't know if Luft means red. You would think, based on the... But that's the class. That's going to be the most popular German song that I'm aware of.
Yeah, name your top three.
Top three German songs. Yeah. Luft Balloons definitely be up there. We've got 98 Luft Balloons, the sequel.
Wouldn't it be 100?
It was a prequel. So I've got a little story that just came across my desk.
This will close us out. We're nearly finished up here on the MacPack sessions.
A man in Pennsylvania has lost his emotional support animal that was quite popular on social media. So he's asked people to look for it. You know, hopefully people can get out and look for it.
What type of animal are we talking
about? It's an alligator. It is an alligator. Yep.
A stuffed alligator.
Yep. It's
Or a real alligator.
No, it's a real alligator.
It's a big boy.
Oh, my gosh.
Surely you can't lose it. Isn't it just in the water?
Come up on land. There's a photo of him hugging it, so I guess it does do its job, the old...
Oh, it's only a little boy. It's not, like, massive. I'm imagining...
It's 5.5 foot.
Okay, so it's... Yeah, but so that... This is an alligator. Like, he'd be shorter than us, significantly.
Yeah, and plus they...
It's 2.5 foot.
They don't stand up on the tail.
No, 1.5 foot, yeah. Wow, there you go.
Yeah, he's lost his alligator. Interesting. I wonder, like...
What does emotional support mean? Does that mean, like, he needs it?
For emotional support.
Wow.
You know, like some people have like a companion.
Yeah, a companion dog.
Yeah, that is...
What classifies emotional support?
I don't know. How could you get it qualified for an alligator?
An alligator. Yeah, because there are things like... There might be places where you can't bring animals, but if someone has like a guide dog or an emotional support animal, you have to let it in.
Yeah.
But I feel like alligator, you might...
If you went to the cricket and you've got a bloke sitting next to you with his pet alligator and he's like, this is my emotional support, I'd be like, man, I feel like I need some emotional support at the moment. Especially. What do you reckon's the weirdest...
I need an emotional support poacher.
What do you reckon is the most hectic animal that you could claim is like your emotional support animal?
An alligator is the one.
Yeah. You reckon that's the top
Even
of the
like,
tree?
I mean, I love them all. Like, good on you for having one, and I appreciate the service that they do, all the animals. But even birds freak me out. Like, yeah, I don't mind a dog. Bird, anything that's on ground, but as soon as it can fly, things get a bit dangerous.
Yeah. Yeah, I agree with that.
Yeah, because, like, dogs usually on a leash.
You couldn't have, like, a goldfish. You couldn't have an emotional support goldfish. You're walking around, like, with a little satchel. A little glad bag. It's not necessarily what you want.
The standard bag. What about, have you guys ever lost something that's had emotional resonance with you?
When I was a kid, I lost my magic 8-ball, which I think Mum may have chucked.
Is that the one you shake?
You shake, yeah. So I'm trying to know what's going on in the world. I can't ask the 8-ball.
His emotional support 8-ball has just disappeared on him.
Yeah, I was so excited the day I got it. Yeah.
Flutters
attack. And then I lost it, yeah.
I got chucked. That's tough.
There you go. I mean, how have you gone on with life since?
Yeah. Well, I ended up buying one at like a good Sammy's for $2.
Oh, there you go.
But that was years later.
The same one.
So now I still ask it stuff.
And is it coming up Millhouse or what?
Yeah, things are looking good.
That's just about our time here on the Saturday morning. You're listening to the Mac Pack here on the Saturday morning. We'll be back. Same time, same place, same bunch of carry-on this time next week. But until then, we got a little bit of Bruce Springsteen with Dancing in the Dark.
Thank you so much for listening to yet another week of us on Radio Fremantle or 107.9.
As you heard, there's a lot of participation.
Or participation.
From the listeners. So if you want to get involved with the show next week or any week after that, make sure you listen in live and hit us up on the Instagram DMs.
Slide into them DMs.
Yes, and if you want to listen to the show with all the music as well, tune in at 107.9, 8 to 10 every Saturday.